Great, happy you can make it. Inside this video right here, I'm gonna be talking about what the day in the life looks like for an EMT and a paramedic. Let's dive into it. Stay tuned to the end of the video. I have some powerful stuff to share with you here that's gonna help you make a decision if this career is right for you. So, the first things first is, depending on what area you're living in, that's gonna determine like, a lot to do with the day in the life. So, first things first, if you are in a major city, you're going to get more calls in a small town, period, right? If you're in a major city, it can get a little chaotic, which some people that are attracted to this career, like myself, may like the chaos. We like to be busy. We have the adrenaline rush, okay? So that may be something that you're looking for in a major city. A smaller town, gonna be a little more relaxed, but there's some other challenges with a small town. Usually, you're farther away from the hospital, so a different variety of call will come up. Now, I just wanna say that first, and I wanna go back to the beginning of your shift. First things first, before we can do any calls, the first thing that an EMT and paramedic must do is check their equipment and check the ambulance. So, with the ambulance, first thing, there's oxygen on board. So there's two different types of oxygen. You have the main oxygen, which is the oxygen in the ambulance, like hooked into the wall. Then you have like the spare oxygen in the back of the stretcher. So those two things need to be checked, as well as obviously the ambulance. It's a moving ER, if you will. That moving ER, it needs some gas, it needs some fuel, right? We gotta make sure that the engine, that everything's working, the oil is good in it, all these things. The lights work. If the lights don't work, and we're going through an intersection with no lights, that's pretty bad. Once that's done, now it's time to check the equipment. So where I've worked has always been an EMT and a paramedic partner. So the way that's kind of been set up is I'll check my equipment, like my ALS meds, my jump bag, like all that kind of stuff, my monitor, while the EMT partner will actually go out and start checking the inside of the ambulance. So I've only worked in EMT and paramedic relationships, so that's usually how that goes. So as a paramedic, what I first do is I just sign off the narcotics. So the narcotics is actually medications that you need to check to make sure that they're in order, okay? These medications are usually locked up, either in a box or they're in a jump bag sealed a certain way depending on your area and where you're at and what you do. Where I've worked, there's a box and there's a key, so you have to check that out, sign it off. These are the first thing that I'll do first. After that, what I'll start doing is checking the medication. So going through all the medications, checking their expiration date, making sure there's no cracks because of, you know, they're glass vials, making sure that those are all good. The next thing that I'll do is make sure I have enough of the medications. And if I need medications, I'll go get more of the medication. It's available. Then from there, checking to make sure I have all my devices and all my equipment needed for that shift, right? Then what I'll do is I'll go check in with my partner, say, hey, how's the ambulance looking? Make sure we have plenty of linen and towels for the stretcher, all that kind of stuff. And if we need anything else, we need more equipment. Usually there's either a storage room that you can go into, or there's a window where you go and get the equipment from, like a supervisor or something like that. And that's how all that works. Now, I am huge and big on this. Actually, what I do is organization. So for example, I've worked at a place where we have like an IV tray, like in the ambulance. I would always like color code that IV tray, right? Yeah, I'm that guy, if you're watching this and you're working in the field. I liked everything super organized. So I would go into the back of the ambulance because primarily as the paramedic, I'm a high level of care, so I'm usually back there more treating patients. So I would want everything really nice and organized, right? So, you know, I have the towels in a certain area, I have my IV tray in a certain area, I have the monitor in a certain way, I have certain stuff on the back of the stretcher. What you're doing here is preparing for your calls. If you are disorganized in the ambulance, then you're gonna be disorganized when you're on a call. If you don't have time to check your equipment, you don't show up to work on time and early to do these things, then you're gonna get burned out in the field. You're gonna miss equipment, you're not gonna have certain things. So I always make sure that I'm fully stocked, that everything's organized, and I have everything that I need to do what I gotta do. So that's basically the checklist. After that, kind of just check in with my partner, hey, make sure we got our, you know, our, if we have a GPS set up, make sure that everything is squared away with that. Depending on where you work, you're either gonna stage out in the field, meaning you're literally going to post in the ambulance for could be 6 hour shift, 8 hour shift, 10 hour shift, 12 hour shift outside of the base, like in the ambulance, and wait for calls. This happens in very busy areas, or in other areas, you actually have a base where you're at and you just hang out in the base and you can do what you gotta do. If you gotta wanna go out and get something, you just go in the ambulance and you wanna get lunch, you go out and go get lunch. So besides that, other stuff around, like, you know, just cleaning up around the base and stuff like that, that's common practice in places that have bases. Cleaning up at the base, you might have some chores, simple stuff like that. But for the most part, you're just hanging out and, you know, waiting for a call to come. But the most important thing about the day in the life is getting yourself prepared. So if you're a new EMT or you're a new paramedic, the biggest thing that I can stress to you, or if you're thinking about getting into this field, is pre-game everything. So what that means is you wanna make sure you're early to shift, and you wanna make sure that you're able to check your equipment and get your ambulance set up the way you like it. Because things happen fast. You do not know what's gonna happen. So I like to be early, get prepped, plenty of time, relax. Now I'm good. Everything's set up beautifully. I'm ready for my calls. And now whatever the day throws at me, I'm ready for it. So guys, this is a day in the life of an EMT of the shift work. Well, it really depends on where you work. So for the most part, you have really like three different options for EMT and paramedics. And I'll throw in a fourth one. I'll give you a bonus, guys. I'm gonna throw in the fourth one. So the first option is working for a fire department, okay? Fire departments put out fires, but also have EMS divisions. Not all of them, but some of them. That's your first option of like where you would actually be working, is a fire department. So you may have heard of like a firefighter EMT or a firefighter paramedic. They're cross-training both. So that is that option. With that option, you're gonna have a base to go back to. So that's the fire department. Now, the other option, which I've worked in, is gonna be a private EMS, like or a private EMS or a hospital-based EMS, all right? So what that looks like in that scenario is gonna be, you're not a fire department, you're not a fireman. You are a EMT and a paramedic, and you're working on the ambulance service. So that area you service will have a fire department, a police department, and for lack of a better word, ambulance service, right? So you are the ambulance service in that case. And in that scenario, depending on where you're at, you might stage out in the field, which is cool, or you might actually have the base. Both are cool, okay? Now, to know, if you're staging out in the field, you go to a base at the beginning of your shift. And then from that base, everyone gets merged off, and you go back to the base when you get back. Just want to make sure that makes sense. Now, the third option is what we call a governmental or a county EMS service. Okay, similar thing. Most of the time that I find, most county services will have a base, but sometimes in busy areas, they'll go stage out, okay? I've done both. Both are cool. And the fourth thing is, well, you could be EMT and paramedic working in the emergency department, where in that case, you're gonna be working in the ER or in a doctor's office, okay? This is getting more and more prevalent. So you may, or in a lab setting, okay? So there's more than just working on the ambulance. You can be in a doc's office, you could be in a lab, right? Or like a clinical trial, you could be in the ER, right? There's certain things that you can do with your EMT and paramedic. If you're gonna be obviously in a clinical trial setting or a doc's office or an ER, it's probably gonna be more of like an 8 hour shift, right? For the most part, maybe a 12 hour shift, right? Maybe in the ER or the hospital. The hospital can be a little different, you know, 16 hour shift sometimes, stuff like that. Guys, if you're looking at the fire department, that could be an example. We have the base, it's like 24 hours on, 48 hours off, something like that. Okay, well, you might work like a whole day, 24 hour shift, then be off for 2 days and then come back and stuff like that, right? Now, on the ambulance service, where I've worked in hospital-based and private EMS, with that option, okay, where I've done my work at, the thing about those options is a variety of shifts. There could be 6 hours, 8 hours, 10 hours, 12, 16 hours. You can do up to 18 hours, okay, of work continuously. So that's basically how these models look, and they're all cool. You gotta decide which one's best for you. I'm gonna give you a bonus tip before I take off. The number one thing when getting in this career is getting started. So whatever you can do to get your foot in the door, to get started with the career, which includes volunteering and applying everywhere that you can, that's the most important thing. So what I've done down below in the link in the description is my Paramedic Coach course for people that are looking to get started with this career, or they're looking to level up from EMT to paramedic, or people that are starting off brand new and they want to get into the field. It's a hybrid course and program. It's an online training and it's an asset to your actual training that you may get in person. That's why I made the course. They found so many providers were coming out of EMT school, but not knowing these essentials to be a great provider. So if you want to learn more, down below in the description is the actual link to the course. It's only $49. You can see on the screen here, people that have gone through the course and gotten these results. So guys, that's it for today's video. I want to thank you so much for supporting me and my journey on this channel. Hit like, subscribe down below if you have not yet. And guys, I will see you in the next one. Take care.